All right. Day one. We're going to slow things down here and do one that we might not have should have done. This is one of my, I can't say new husband-in-law because that's been a long time ago, but a good friend of ours wrote this song a long time ago. And thank goodness it's been a long time ago, I guess. If I can find the right key here, we're going to do it in. We're going to have some more fun tonight. And it's called, is that right? That's wrong, isn't it? I told you, boys, you got to go down. We hope you like this one. This is one of our favorite songs that we've ever recorded in the past few years. It goes like this. Imagine a world where no music was playing. And think of a church with nobody praying. If you've ever looked up at a sky with no blue, then you've seen a picture of me without you. Have you walked in a garden where nothing was growing? Or stood by a river when nothing was flowing? If you've ever looked up at a sky with no blue, then you've seen a picture of me without you. Can you picture heaven with no angels singing on Sunday morning with no church bells ringing? If you've watched as the heart of child breaks in two, then you've seen a picture of me without you. Without you. Thank you. Now I'm just a bartender, and I don't like my work, but I don't mind the money at all. I see lots of sad faces and lots of bad cases of folk with their backs to the wall. I still need four walls around me to hold my life, to keep me from going astray. I need a honky tonk angel to hold, help keep me from slipping away. I can light up your smokes, I could laugh at your jokes, I could watch you fall down on your knees, I could close down this bar, go and gas up my whole car, and I could pack up, pull out and down in that one little key. I'd still need four walls around me to hold my life, to keep me from going or lost track. Don't you know I need me a honky tonk angel to hold me tight, to help keep me from slipping where I am. Now the smoke fills the air, and this honky-tonk bar, and I'm thinking about where I'd rather be. But I burned all my bridges, and I sank all my ships. Now I'm stranded at the edge of the sea. I still need four around me to hold my life, to keep me from coming or going straight. I need a honky tonk angel to hold me tight. Maybe one could help George from slipping.
Welcome to the City Beautiful, Orlando, Florida, home of Church Street Station. We're here at the Cheyenne Saloon and Opera House to bring you 30 minutes of the best in live country music. This week on Church Street Station, a country music legend in his own time, Mr. George Jones. Well, if you've got to arrive in a car, this is the car to arrive in. I'd say that car is older than the chauffeur. But old George won't let that stop him. And it's not going to stop us either. So let's follow him inside, along with a friend or two, or three, or 3,000 inside the Cheyenne Saloon. Thank you for the lift, Milani. Now let's follow George to the stairs as he straps on his guitar. Well, not these stairs. Well, whatever. We're in for a treat from the one and only Mr. George Jones.
How y'all doing? All right, I can see right now we're going to have a great time here tonight. It's Church Station, I tell you. We look forward to this for a long time. I'm all the way here tonight, and Ron over here is going to do a little part of Merle Haggard. We're going to start off with this one right now.
Well, George, did you know Waylon and Willie are the Outlaws?
I didn't know that at all, sir.
Did you know Roger Green is the king of the road?
Somebody told me that.
Everyone knows Hank's been in prison.
We know that.
And Dolly's got two big reasons she well known. They call me No Show.
They call me No Show.
They call me No Show Jones.
Ain't that good? That's what I'm on.
Here's Merle. Loretta. Here's a coal miner's daughter.
Oh, she's mighty pretty.
Johnny wears black and stands all alone.
Ooh, that's lonesome.
Everyone knows Kitty is a gambler.
Nah, I didn't know that.
How about Tammy? Tammy had some kind of excuse. She divorced George Jones. They call me No Show.
song's especially for all you girls tonight. I've had good luck, bad luck, no luck, it's true, but I've always been lucky. I've been turned on and turned down when the bars close at 2, but I've always been lucky with you. I keep 2 strikes against me most all of the time. When it's down to just a moment, I mind as a dime. I've had good days, bad days, but when my day is through, and I've always got lucky.
Y'all, it goes like this. Y'all been so wonderful.
Tell me how she was when you once knew her. How she played her games with many, many men. And you tell me you don't think I'd still be with her. If I could just have known her way back then.
Lord, you ask me why I don't back up and leave her. Now that I know about her wicked ways, hey, I doubt that you could understand my thinking. But listen close to what we have to say. She's the rock that I lean on.
She's the sunshine of my day.
I don't care what you say about her.
Lord, she took me in and made me everything I am today. She's my rock and I ain't gonna throw her away. I know she never was once what she is now. Lord, she had to make mistakes like everyone else.
Hey, but don't you point your finger at nobody. Lord, it's plain to see that you ain't no saint yourself. She's the rock
sunshine of my day. And I don't care what you say about her. Lord still made me everything I am today.
That's right.
She's my rock and I ain't gonna throw her away. I said she's my rock and I ain't gonna throw her away.
Hey,
she's my rock and I ain't gonna throw her away. And there's a pickle in the middle and a mustard on top.
Chicken reel.
Please welcome a very talented and mi compadre, Mr. Johnny Rodriguez.
Wish I was holding someone somewhere else tonight. About a thousand miles north of here would just about be right. I left Houston on a southbound train about a year ago. Bound to forget your face here in Orlando. All these warm summer nights, guitars and soft white lace. But in every senorita smile I see your face. I just hope like hell the little ring still on your hand. I'm gonna pack it up tonight if I can't catch a flight. My friend, it ain't sunny Mexico, but Lord, it's such a beautiful town. If there's a light in the window, I know you're waiting on me. And if you'll open up your arms just one more time, that's where with my Texas queen invaded me.
voy a dedicar a toda la raza. Anybody that speaks Spanish will understand part of this one also. Cuando calienta el sol aquí en la playa, siento tu cuerpo vibrar cerca de mí. Y es tu palpitar, es tu cara, es tu pelo, con tus besos me estremezco. Oh, love me with all your heart, that's all I want, love. Love me with all your heart, as I love you. And don't give me your love for a moment or an hour. Love me always as you've loved me from the start. And when we are far apart, all when you're near me, love me with all your heart or not at all. And don't give me your love for a moment or an hour. Love me always as you love me from the start. With every beat of your heart. Cuando calienta el sol aquí en la playa, siento tu cuerpo vibrar cerca de mí. Palpitar tu recuerdo, mi locura, mi delirio, me estremezco. Cuando calienta el sol,
this old world is full of sinners, all but just a few chosen. Tear your heart out when they sing. Imagine life without them. Hold your radio heroes like the outlaw that walks through Jesse's dream. Oh, they'll never be another red-headed stranger, a man in black and false prison blue. They all came from Muskogee. Hello, darling. Lord, I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes. Who's gonna fill their shoes? Who's gonna stand that tall? Who's gonna play the opera and the Wabash Cannonball? Who's gonna give their heart and soul to get to me and you? Lord, I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes? God bless the boys from Memphis. Blue suede shoes and Elvis. Much too soon he left this world in tears. They tore up the 50s. Old Jerry Lee and Charlie and Go Cat Go still echoes through the years. You know the heart of country music still beats in Luke the Drifter. You could tell it when he sang, I saw the light. Old Marty, Hank and Lefty, why can you feel him right here on the silver eagle rolling through the night? Who's gonna feel their
guess I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes.
Please welcome an unusually talented young performer, Mark Gray, and Diamond in the Dust.
She's just a country girl, quietly living life, and never thought of giving away her love. She looked at me through willing eyes, as if I understood she could have her way with me, she would. She was a diamond in the dust, shine beneath the rust, someone that I could trust. Trust, come out home. She was the rose beside the bone.
goodness, I'm telling you. Y'all are so wonderful tonight here at Church Street Station, I tell you. I don't know what took us long to get down here, but we've been wanting to get on this show and get down in this part of the country for a long time. Of course, we're almost a Floridian anyhow, ourselves, because we used to live right over at Lakeland, and we still do. Got some great friends over there. We're happy to be here tonight. I'll tell you what, we might stay till 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning as long as they'll film us. I just want to know one thing. Are you ready?
Yeah! Well, I feel tears welling up, pulling deep inside like my heart from a big bird. And the stab of loneliness sure been painful. I may never shame. But you might say that I was taking it hard when you wrote what was it called? Don't you wager that'll hide the sorrow when I may live right down and fall. Hey, the race is on. Here comes pride at the backstretch. Heartache going to the inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running. Roof of scratch for another shade. The race is on. It looks like heartache. Hey, no, no, loses all. One day I ventured in love, never once suspecting what the final results would be. How did the girl waking up each morning, thinking that you'd gone for me?
Well, there's aching and pain in
my heart for the girl, the one that I hated to pay. Somebody new came up, and when her I wound up in a 14 play.
Shh, sure, the race is
on. Here comes right up the back street. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running. Room I'm scratched for another say. The race is on. It looks like heartache. And the winner loses all.
Hey, hey, hey.
The winner keeps losing it all. Just a bartender, and I don't like my work, but I don't mind the money at all. I see lots of sad faces, lots of bad cases of folks with their backs to I need four walls around me to hold my life, to keep me from going, Lord, astray. I need a honky-tonk angel to hold me tight and help keep me from slipping away. I can light up your smokes. I can laugh at your jokes. I can watch you fall down on your knees. I can close down this bar, go and gas up my old car. All I can pack up, oh Lord, in my old Yankee. I still need four walls around me to hold my wife, life, to keep me from going, Lord, astray. Need me
anyone could help little George to keep from slipping away. Smoke fills the air, and this honky tonk boy, and I'm thinking about where I'd rather be. But I burned all my bridges, and I sank all my ships. Now I'm stranded at the edge of. I still need four walls around me to hold my life, to keep me from going, oh Lord, astray. I need a honky tonk angel to hold me tight and help me from slipping away. Yeah. He said, I'll love you till I die. She told him, forget it. I watched the years pass slowly by. She still preyed upon his mind. Kept her picture on his wall. Went half crazy now, but he still loved her through it all. Kept hoping she'd come back again. They found love letters by his bed, dated 1962. He had underlined in red every single "I love you." I went to see my friend today. Oh, and I didn't see no tear. All dressed up to go away. First time I'd seen smiling year. He stopped loving her today. They placed a ring upon his door. Soon they'll carry him away. He stopped loving her today. You know, she came back today for a last time. Oh, and we all wondered if she would. And it kept running through my mind. Well, this time, he's over her for good. He stopped loving her today. They placed a ring upon. Stop loving her today. I want to know one thing. Now, when I ask that, I got about 4 or 5 watts, and I need a whole house full of watts. I'm going to ask you again, though, see? And I need a whole house full of watts when I ask you that question, because it kind of leads me into this next little spasm of a song. Y'all ready? I want to know one thing. Who's going to chop my baby's kindling when I'm gone? Who's going to chop my baby's kindling when I'm gone? Who's going to tote in all of that wood and do the little bitty little things I should? Who's going to chop my baby's kindling when I'm gone? Hey, when I'm gone, when I'm long gone, who's going to chop my baby's kindling when I'm gone?
When I'm gone,
who's going to tote in all that wood, do the little bitty little things I should? Who's going to chop my baby's kindling when I'm gone? We're going to chop a little kindling right now. I stopped off at the quick sack for some beer and cigarettes. The old man took my money as he stared at my Corvette. He said I had one just like her son, 1963. Hell, a man down at the bank took her from me. Lord, she was
my $2 pistol.
She was the fastest thing around. Long and lean, every young man's dream turned to the head and down. She was quick and hot, Daniel's son, glad that you dropped in. She reminds me of the one I loved back then. So I handed him the keys and said, here, take her for a spin. The old man shook his head and then he looked at me and grinned. I don't think you understand, son, it ain't the car I want. It's the brunette in your bed that turned me on. My Lord, she was hotter than a $2 pistol. She was the fastest thing around. Long and lean, every young man turned up a head and down. She was quick and hot to handle, son. I'm glad that you dropped in. She reminds me of the one I loved back then. Lord, she was
hotter than a $2 pistol.
She was the fastest thing around. Long and lean, every young man's dream turned up a head and down. She was quick and hot to handle, son. I'm glad that you dropped in. She's the one I used to love way back then. She reminds me of the one I loved back then. Goodbye, God bless you.
Friends, if you were to take a vote in Nashville as to who was the favorite country male singer of country stars, 9 times out of 10, my guest would win the vote. In country music, he is the singer's singer. Please make welcome the man with the golden voice, Mr. George Jones.
Now I'm just a bartender. Don't like my work, but I don't mind the money at all. I see lots of sad faces and lots of bad cases of the folks with their backs to the wall. But I need four walls around me to hold my life and keep me from going astray.
need a honky tonk angel to hold me tight. They'll help keep me from slipping away.
I can light up your smokes. I could laugh at your jokes.
I could watch you fall down on your knee.
I could close down this bar,
go and gas up my old car. Lord, I could pack up, hey, mail in my key. I'd still need four walls around me to hold my life and keep me from going astray. I need a honky tonk angel to hold me tight. She'll help keep me from slipping away.
Now the smoke fills the air,
in this honky-tonk bar. Lord, I'm thinking about where I'd rather be.
Well, I burned all the bridges
and I sank all the ships, and now I'm stranded at the edge of the sea. I still need four walls around me to hold my life and keep me from going on straight. I need a honky-tonk angel to hold me tight and keep me from slipping away.
Oh, you're something else.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Wonderful people up here in Canadian country, I guarantee you. We'd like to do one even sadder than that, Ronnie. Cameron, good. Y'all don't mind? Goes like this.
Someday my day will come. I won't need a thing at all. I can stand proud and tall and say just what I feel. Someday my day will come when dreams become reality. I'll be the one I wanna be. Someday my day will come. It's a tiring, we all travel through, but it's still I take Lord and set back too. We all have roles in life to play, and I'll play a great one someday my day will come. I'll hold true love
love right in my hands. I'll touch pretty rainbows in, and my cup will overflow. Someday my day will come. I'll watch my ship as it comes in, and my castles won't be made of sand. Someday my day will come. I'll hold true love right in my hand. Someday my day will come.
My man, that is absolutely the greatest. So great to have you on the show. What praising. He's too much. Hey, we've got more good country music coming after these messages, so stay with us, okay?
I'd like to hear you do another song.
Let's go.
Well, in North Carolina, way back in the hills, Bill Moore's heaven and the heaven still. He brewed white light until the sun went down. Then he filled him a jug and he passed it around. Mighty, mighty pleased, back was gonna squeeze him.
Ooh, I like it.
Well, a G-man team and a revenue's too, searching for a place for the main school. They were looking, trying to book it, my peppy kept cooking.
Shoo, I like it.
Well, a city slicker came and he said, I'm tough, I think I want to taste that powerful stuff. He took one from Slug and drank it on down. I heard him a moaning as he hit the ground. Mighty, mighty pleasing, my pappy's corn squeezing.
Whew, I like him.
Well, a G-man team and a revenue's too, searching for a place where he made it through. They were looking, trying to book him, but my pappy kept on cooking.
Ooh, I like him.
Well, you painted up your lips and rolled and curled your tinted hair. Ruby, are you contemplating going out somewhere? Well, the shadows on the wall tell me the sun is going down. Oh, Ruby, don't take your love to town. Well, she's leaving now, cause I just heard the slamming of the door. The way I know, I've heard it slam 100 times before. If I could move, I'd get my gun, I'd put her in the ground. Oh, Ruby, don't take your love to town.
I've heard the sound of my dear old mama crying, and the sound of a train that took me off to war, and the awful sound of a thousand bombs
And I wondered if I could take it anymore. And of earthquakes, storms, guns and wars, Lord, nothing has ever hurt me more than that lonely sound, the closing of the door.
I walk alone where once we wandered. It seems so strange that you are gone.
You know, George, if we didn't let Farron join in on some of the singing, it would just be uncountry, wouldn't it?
It certainly would.
Well, why don't we let him help us on one of your great songs called Tender Years?
That's a pretty one. You start off, George.
You keep saying you love me. I believe that it's true, and it just doesn't matter how much I love you.
But in time you'll understand, dear, when you get a tear,
then you'll know you were living in your tender years. If I can be your first love, and I'll wait and be your last, I'll be somewhere in the future to help you forget the past.
And you'll know that I love you with a love that's sincere.
Yes, I'll wait till you're through living in your tender years.
Oh, give me the high part there.
There is no way that could have been done any better. That was a trio of the year. That's about all the time we have for tonight, friends, but I want to say thanks to Farron Young for stopping by. And, of course, a special thanks to my good friend George Jones for being in the spotlight tonight.
Thank you, Marty. I was supposed to tell a story on George, and I know a large amount of him. Of course, he knows a large amount of him on me, so we kind of weighed each other out, you know. He's a singing son of a bitch, let me tell you. George Jones, where you at, Hoss?
You something else, Hoss.
I'm glad to be here.
By the way, let's do a new one. Let's do a new one.
A long time forgotten, the dreams that just fell by the way. The good life he promised, they once living today.
Hit him up.
Oh, but she never complained of the bad times or the bad things she's done. She just talks about the good times they had long.
Good time.
She's a good-hearted woman in love with a good time and man. Yeah. Who loves him in spite of his ways that she don't understand. Through teardrops and laughter, they'll pass in each world. Life and good time and friends,
don't we all? Ain't no bad deal.
When the party's all over, she'll welcome him back home.
One way or another, yeah.
Lord knows she don't understand him, but love the best she can, all right. Woo! Lord, this good part of the with a good time and man. Through teardrops and laughter, they'll pass through this world hand in hand.
He said, I love you till I die. She told him, forget and turn. I watched the years pass slowly by. She still prayed on his mind. He kept her picture on his wall. Went half crazy now and then, but he still loved her through it all. Kept hoping she'd come back again. Found love letters by his bed. Did it 1962. She had underlined in red every single "I love you." I went to see my friend today, but I didn't see no tears. He was all dressed up to go away. First time I'd seen him 20 years. He stopped loving her again. He placed a ring upon his door. Soon they'll carry him away. But he stopped loving her today. You know, she came back today for the last time. Oh, and we all wondered if she would. And it kept running through my mind. Well, this time, he's over her for good. He stopped loving her today. It placed a reef upon his door. And soon they'll carry him away. He stopped loving her today. Thank you. Bless you.
So I'm going. If I could put them all together, I'd have you. If I could put them all together, I'd have you.
Thank you so much. Y'all are something else. Bars running. It's four in the morning. I must have shut it all down by the shape that I'm in. I lay my head on the wheel and the whole neighborhood knows little Jones is home drunk again. And if drinking it don't kill me, her memory will. I can't hold out much longer with the blood from my body. I could start hold my own still for These old bones, they move slow,
but they're sure on
their footsteps
as I trip on the floor.
And a light leads us down. Oh Lord, it's been
20 bottles since I tried to forget her, but the memory still lingers,
lying here on good old Louisiana ground.
And if drinking it don't kill me, her memory,
well, I can't hold out
much longer.
Lord, the way I'm feeling now, with the blood
from my body,
we could start our own steel.
And if all this drinking don't kill me,
Devin's memory. These old bones, they move slow,
but they're sure on their footsteps as I trip on the floor.
And I lightly touch down.
Oh Lord, it's been 10 bottles since I tried to forget her, but the memory still lingers
like
I would soon get over you. I would find somebody to. Time and tears have come and gone, but not your memory. But I'll be over you when the grass grows over me. Yes, I'll be over you when you're standing over me. And as you look down at the cold, cold ground I'm sleeping in, don't expect to hear me say that I still love you then. For I'll be over you when the grass grows over me. Even when my eyes are closed, they keep on seeing you. Every minute I move by, I'm hurt through and through. And as long as I live, I know I won't be free. For I'll be I'll be over you when you're standing over me. And as you look down at the cold, cold ground I'm sleeping, don't expect to hear me say that I still love you again. For I'll be
wonderful. Real great. George Jones, when he sings a song, it has been sung. So I give you a word of advice. Don't try to follow him when it comes to singing one.
George.
I'll share my world with you. Everything that I own, my earthly possessions, they're no good if I'm alone. Let me bring you sunshine while it's fresh before you. Can't you see? Share my world with you. If you'll be mine alone, I'll give you a new heart. You're the only love it's known. Let me give you my tears. They'll be smiling. I'll share my world with you. Everything that I see, divide all memories, one for you and one for me. Let me give you my two. They'll be happy if you do.
my tail, I'm waiting for the dinner bell. I'm putting humans on. Every day them fools rush in, they lay down the cash and watch me grin. I put them all on, I'd hum a little song, I'd watch them all go tee. But I spell a pee, a little bit of heat. Speak bop bop bop, shadoomy dooby do, and a little round on. Then you add another pee, a big skinny L, plus a one or more in, you got a creature that looks like me. And someone knocked on my door today, there'd be a little sign just gone away. Down to the zoo, a nigga you know who, cause I'm a pee. Feet, all he do is scratch his fleas. Oh me, what luxury. But I'm a pee boy, and I spell a pee, a little bit of e. Squeak bop bop bop, shoo doo 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 doo, and a little round o. Then you add another pee, a big skinny L, plus a one more e, and you got a people that looks like me. Is gone away down to the zoo, a digging you know who, cause I'm a people. The night shift got off early because of major retired. I stopped off for a drink on my way. I didn't know that you loaned out the dress that I bought for you to wear. Sweetheart, tell me my life has grown. I thought I saw you kissing me as you danced across the floor. But I knew that you were with the kids at home. I thought I saw a baby sit, meet me at the door. Sweetheart, tell me. Tell me my life has gone wrong.
Thank you. Y'all are something else. You know, we did a song already that Tom T. Hall, one of my favorite songwriters, one of my favorite singers, and one of my favorite people that is on the show tonight, that you're going to see it a little bit later on tonight, and you're going to have a thrill. He wrote this song that we had out a couple, three records back. And I heard it on an album that Tom T did, and I just couldn't resist it because it was one of the prettiest things I thought I'd heard in a long time. Here's our rendition of it, and it goes like this. I've always said that someday I'd have to leave you. Some April, while all the land is wet, some spring, summer, fall, Lord, or maybe winter. But I'm still around, and I'm not ready yet. I know I should have left the day I knew your love was dying, but I passed up every day that I ever saw. But I know I'll hear when my heart tells me. I'm still here, and I'm not ready yet. You know I must have left you 100 times, but I know you don't know that. 'Cause I was afraid, I was ashamed that you might laugh if you found out just how far I'd get. But you did, and you don't. And I know you ain't gonna ever love me, but someday I'll go. Right now I'm just not ready yet. I know I should've left I did before you ever knew, but I passed up on every day this old boy ever said. But I know I'll leave when my heart tells me. Well, George, I think this time we're ready. But I'm still here, and I'm not ready. You know, the late and great Hank Williams Sr. once said, you win again, and I'm not ready.
Join the gang for a toe-tapping half hour of fun and music on Country Social, starring George Jones and the Jones Boys, Connie Smith, Bozo Darnell, the Country Social Dancers, and our special guest, Johnny Cash. Brought to you by...
Hello, everybody. My name is Danny Williams, and we want to thank all of you for letting us come into your house today with Country Social. We got the finest country music for you, and we're certainly going to be sociable. We're going to send out a love and a lot of warmth, and I'll guarantee you that any moment now, coming right through your tube, is going to be a little bitty bug full of love. As a matter of fact, it's the love bug, and George Jones done got it captured, and he's going to let it go.
Well, I was ruling the roost and had all the chicks to myself, and then suddenly it happened, a funny little feeling I felt. Well, but how could a woman something the dark can't see? Oh, that little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. Nobody's ever seen, but it's got the whole world shook. It all started with a little bitty kiss and a hug. It's a little bitty teeny weeny thing they call.
bug is a lot more fun than chiggers, and it don't take near as much fingernail polish.
Beautiful song, very beautiful.
Thank you, and here's George Jones.
Thank you. And welcome to that good old Nashville music. And along with Tammy and myself this week, along with all the Jones boys, our special guest will be Miss Patsy Sled and Harold Morrison, that banjo picking king from Nashville, Tennessee. And Tammy, since you didn't let me tell you to go sit down over there, I'm glad you went over there and sit down, because I want to sing this next song especially for you. It goes a little bit like this. Well, here we are. Alone, just us two. Where the lights are dim and true love is coming through. There's no one else in this whole world, as far as we're concerned. We build ourselves a fire, so let it burn. When you look at me like you do right now, I go to pieces, because I know it's just me. You've got that ball in your eyes like you've heard so many times and times. Loving you could never be better than it is right now. Tomorrow night we'll meet again, two once more than the flame. 'Cause loving you the way I do stays the same. This love of ours is just as strong as any vow could be. And love I know what's on your mind.
Well, I feel tears welling up cold and deep inside, like my heart's from a big break, and the staff of loneliness, sure painful. I may never say, but you might say that I was taking it hard when you wrote me over the call. But don't you wager that'll hide the sorrow when I'm in the right down and ball. Well, the race is on. Here comes pride up the backstretch. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running. Much stress for another set. The race is on. It looks like hardly. And the winner loses all.
He blessed me. Who's my favorite country artist? And I say, you mean besides George Jones? If we could all sound like we wanted to, it'd all sound like George Jones.
It's almost like he's lived every minute of every word that he sings, and there's very few people that can do that.
It was always Jones that seemed to get the message across just exactly right.
Man, he stole everybody's heart. He stole my heart.
One day I ventured in love, never once suspecting what the final results would be. How I live in fear of never waking up each morning thinking that you're gone from me. Well, there's aching and pain in my heart, for the day was the one that I hated to face. Somebody new came up to win her. I wound up in a 14th place.
George put so much emotion, so much feeling into his songs, and that's what it's all about.
I would give anything if I could sing like George Jones.
He touches an emotion
like few other people in this business had ever touched, or I think ever will touch.
He can still stroll out on the stage, strap on that guitar and start singing and knock you right out of your seat.
Hey, hey, hey. When is losing it all?
The people of the Big Thicket, as they call this isolated area of East Texas, are breed apart with their own moral code and a strict creed that became the community's only law. It was a wild, untamed region populated by the descendants of those who were often fleeing the laws of the outside world. Forbidding and inhospitable, this was the land that time forgot. Few who left have escaped its dark and sinister emotional hold. Few who left failed to return. The Big Thicket town of Saratoga continues to bear the scars of the Great Depression that seemed to lay particularly heavy on the rural settlements of the South. For the people who made up these tiny communities, theirs was a life of hardship and poverty, broken only by the simplest of life's pleasures, children, family, and of course, the traditional music that had been handed down from generation to generation and seemed to have the power to sweep away the darkest clouds. It was in this small log cabin that George Glenn Jones first drew breath on September 12, 1931, the last child of eight born to Clara and George Washington Jones. His father was a hard-drinking but hard-working man who took work where he could find it. His mother was a religious woman who prodded young George to sing at the small church where she played piano.
I learned my first chords on the guitar after my daddy finally bought me one, I think, when I was about 9 years old. And I loved music so much, and I went to this little church, Sister Annie and Brother Burl Stevens. She taught me my first chords on the guitar, like C, G, and D, and things like that. And I started hanging out over there more often, you know, and she'd get her guitar, and we'd pick and sing together.
He's the lily of the valley, oh, the bright morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul.
Well, something like that, lily of the valley. We used to do all the real old, the old gospel songs.
If gospel music was George's first influence, it would not be his last. The Texas oil boom of the mid-30s brought more prosperous and happier times to the Jones clan, along with the family's first radio. This was the stuff from which dreams were made.
Saturday nights would be the only time my dad would ever allow one of the kids to lay in bed with him. And he would let me lay in bed between them and listen to the Grand Ole Opry. And I'd tell my mother, I'd say, "Mama, you wake me up if I go to sleep when Roy Acuff or Bill Monroe comes on." And sure enough, I'd go to sleep, and she'd wake me up.
With the Second World War came new prosperity to the urban centers of the South, and George Washington Jones gathered up his family and moved south from the Big Thicket to the bustling port city of Beaumont. It was here that a young George Jones found a whole new dimension to his singing talents.
Way back in the hills. It was on a Sunday, and there wasn't too much traffic downtown on a Sunday, just a few people window shopping. I was just sitting there playing my guitar, Precious Jewel and Wabash Cannonball and all them things like that. Finally, a little handful of people would stop and gather and just listen, since they didn't have anything else to do, you know. I wound up leaving there with about $27, and that's more money than I'd ever seen in my life. Here I am doing something that I love more than anything in the world, and I still do today. And then I found out that there were other people, Mike, that would like it, that might like it. And when I found that out, that just put it all over the top.
In 1949, a young singer emerged from the wilds of Alabama who would have a profound influence on all of country music for years to come. In him, George found a mentor and guiding light who would influence his life for the good and the bad in the long years ahead.
But Hank Williams came along, and oh my goodness,
I couldn't think or eat nothing unless it was Hank Williams. And I couldn't wait for his next record to come out. He was, had to be really the greatest.
By the time George was in his late teens, he had already begun his journey up the long lost highway that Hank Williams had paved, living the lifestyle that would soon take its final toll on Hank. In May of 1949, George actually met his idol when Hank came through Beaumont to promote his latest single. It was a moment George would never forget. A year later, George met and married his first wife, Dorothy. In no less time than it took for Dorothy to get pregnant, they had separated. For George, it was time to find work of a more secure nature.
I had my first daughter by my first wife, and to be honest with you, that was the main reason I went to service, because I couldn't pay my child support.
Even though it's the height of the Korean War, the only action George will see during his two-year stint is in the bars and beer halls of San Jose, California, where he appears as Little Georgie Jones, the Forrester Hill Flash.
I came in off of Liberty, and my friend next to me on the bunk next to me had came in about within 5 minutes after I came in, and I had just got my clothes off to lay down, and he brought in the morning paper and showed it to me, and I laid there the rest of the morning just bald, you know, and it just broke my heart, you know, because the Lord, he was just everything as far as I was concerned.
Sad news to begin this New Year's Day. Hank Williams was found dead this morning in the back seat of his Cadillac while on the way to a performance in Canton, Ohio. His death has been attributed to a heart attack from excessive drinking. A tragic start to 1953.
Back in Beaumont, the local music scene is thriving, with artists like Lefty Frizzell and a new independent record label headed up by Harold Pappy Daly.
Star Day was started with Starnes and Daly. The name Starnes and Daly became Star Day, the name of the label. And Jack Starnes and Neva Starnes lived in Beaumont. And Beaumont is where George lived. So when George got discharged from the Marines, he came back and started playing the joints around Beaumont. And Jack Starnes recorded, the first time he recorded George, I think it was a song called No Money in This Deal. And it was done, I think, in Jack Starnes' living room with a Magna Quarter.
Well, I can meet you on the street, and I'll stop and talk to you. You can walk around the block, and I will walk around it too. We can sit down in the park, do some loving in the dark. But to me, you don't appeal, cause there ain't no money in this deal.
While No Money in This Deal is only a regional hit, it brings fame and fortune enough to draw George slowly but surely into the clutches of the music industry star-making machinery. However, outside of the Houston Beaumont area, George is dismissed as trying to sound too much like his influences Hank Williams, Lefty Frizzell, and Roy Acuff.
We all told him and kept on, and it took a while to get it across that you've got to be original, you've got to be yourself, and come out with something different, or you're not going to make it.
For something original, you had to look no further than Memphis, where, goodness gracious, rock and roll was ready to rule the roost.
Rock and roll was eating our lunch, brother. It practically put us out of business. And we had to put as many as four names on a bill to fill an auditorium.
George Jones would have been a really hot rockabilly artist if he had approached it from that angle. Well, he was really, but never really got the recognition for it.
Well, I tried one record of it, and I didn't want my name on it. And it was called Rocket, and Dadgummit, How Come It. And I'm still embarrassed today when I'm asked about it.
George should have remembered what Hank Williams had told him. Don't try to be someone else when you sing. Just be yourself.
Tell me why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why you make me cry, baby, cry, baby, cry, baby, cry. Lord, I can't help but love you till the day that I die. So tell me why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why.
1955 and 56, the first one I ever had.
As George's record sales increased and his popularity grew, the road began to beckon as he was becoming increasingly more in demand as a concert performer. In the South, all roads led to Shreveport, and George was soon on the bill of the prestigious Louisiana Hayride, the grooming ground for Nashville-bound performers. It was on the hayride that George Jones met and played with Elvis Presley and Johnny Cash.
We became friends the first night we worked together. He's that kind of man. Felt like I'd known him all my life. About the second time that I saw him there, he invited me to go home and spend the weekend with him in Beaumont. So we left Shreveport and went from Shreveport to Beaumont after the hayride that night. And I remember the songs we sang and the things George was into. George had an attitude about life and about things like that that was awfully unburdening. Be depressed or down about the night we just passed together. And he had come up with a joke about it, you know, and laugh about how bad he felt. And I guess George is one of the first people I ever learned from to laugh through my pain. And especially if that pain is self-inflicted, don't take yourself serious, you know.
Back in those days, George, you couldn't tell what that little bastard was liable to do.
He got out in West Texas, and he got in a scrape out there, and they threw him in the cooler for overnight, and Pappy Daly had to get him out and brought him over to Houston, and George was needing some work and needing some money, and he got him a gig for $2,500, I believe it was. So George did the gig and then got on a party and came in to see Pappy the next day and needing some money. And Pappy says, well, George, you just made $2,500, but I talked to some of the guys you were partying with and they said you went and flushed it down the toilet. He says, Pappy, that's a damn lie. It wasn't but $1,200.
More important than money to George was the chance of a lifetime to appear on the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville's Ryman Auditorium.
Well, that name, Grand Ole Opry, means so very much. It's so much prestige to it. When we were coming along, me, George Jones, at that period, the Grand Ole Opry was like Hollywood to the actor. And once you reached the Grand Ole Opry, you were well on your way.
I was just so nervous. This was the biggest thing that could ever happen to anybody in the world. And I was just shaking. I mean, just truly shaking all over. And Dickens and Morgan was trying to calm me down, and they wasn't going to let me play my guitar because I didn't belong to the local here. But they, one or the other, poked that guitar right in my hand and said, here, we'll take responsibility. You just get on the stage.
Friends and neighbors, a big Grand Ole Opry welcome for his first appearance on this stage. Let's hear it for George Jones.
Oh, you said you was my baby. Now I know that you're my baby, but it seems to me that you've got roving eyes. If you want
to
be
I went
my
out
baby,
to do my what I thought was a big hit at the time, you know. You Gotta Be My Baby, I think it was. And I thought I was doing pretty good, you know, and I was waiting for him to give me a hand. And yeah, I got a little classy, you know. Well, I said, well, I'm glad to be off of there anyhow.
Hi out there, and welcome to the Ozark Mountains of Missouri. We're about to have another country music jubilee starring Red Foley.
A young recording star that a lot of you folks have been kind of sort of nudging us along to get on our show is here with us tonight. A nice welcome, please, for George Jones. George, where are you, huh?
Oh, here you are. Here on the side.
Mr. Red, thank you very much. George, you're really plowing a real wide furrow in this business these days for a fellow so young. But right now, let's hear one of those tunes that you wrote and sort of kept for yourself instead of writing and letting somebody else record all your songs. When you have Alan Mercury Records now, what's the name of it, Randy?
I expect you're talking about the one called Into My Arms Again.
That's it, boy.
As the decade drew to a close, there was a change in George. His voice had grown deeper, and his vocal style had matured and become distinctly his own.
The music from the honky-tonk, the lonely songs they play, coming through my window, cause I live not far away. They're tempting me to come back to the things we used to do, but the honky-tonk and lonely songs I left behind when I left you.
He never had to be taught to sing from the heart. George knew no other way.
The way he can perform it, the way he does it with his voice, the type of voice that I use, and then drops into that deep baritone bass voice, it's just remarkable how he can do those things. And I wished I could do it. I don't know anyone else that can do that.
And come away from the honky-tonk back into my arms. Won't you come away from the honky-tonk back into my arms again?
Through the 60s, George and I, both of us, we heated up pretty good, and we toured a lot together. I remember this one time in Regina, Saskatchewan. There was just the two of us on the show, and we was always arguing about who was going to open the show and who was going to close it. I see. You go on every night last. Why can't I go on be the star tonight? Why can't I go on last? And no, George, you got to go on first again tonight.
This is when Buck was really hot, you know, and had these number ones right after the other.
And I said, okay, when I get through out there tonight, you come watch my show. And I said, you come to the curtain there at the side and you watch my show. And I said, Buck, when I get through tonight, you ain't going to want to even go out there.
George got drunk. And walked out on the stage. He was having Buck the headline, right? He opened up. And he walked out on the stage and done Buck's show.
I didn't sing on one of my songs. I did his whole show.
And he came off of the stage and he looked over me and said, it's your turn. I will never forget that.
Well, in North Carolina, way back in the hill, lived my old pappy and he had him a still. He brewed a white lightning till the sun went down, then he filled him a jug and he'd pass it around. Mighty, mighty pretty and Baptist corn squeezing. Shh, white lightning. Well, a GMT and a river nurse too, searching for a place where he made his brew. They were looking, trying to book him, but my pappy kept a cooking. Ooh, white lightning.
We had some great times together. I toured with George as much as I did anybody else in the earlier years, and we toured together all the way from Washington State to Nova Scotia to South Texas.
And we traveled many, many, many miles cramped up like that, and usually most every date was a drive on that night.
We would work the long tours. Back then you'd go out and sometimes work 15 to 20 days at a time.
When you're on the road, you don't eat right, you don't sleep right, and this keeps your body dragged out.
White lightning.
We were in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, 34 below zero, and that place was sold out, and they were trying to put all the instruments in the car, and they all got frostbitten noses and ears, and I sure do remember it. I don't know. I think when they woke up the next morning, I don't know whether they remembered it too well or not.
Those long tours like that are over, but it was a lot of fun. It was what I like to call the singing 60s.
Mug and he drank it on down, and I heard him a-moaning as he hit the ground. Mighty, mighty freeze, and your back is corn squeezing. Ooh, what lightning.
After 5 years of grinding tours, George is back home in Beaumont with his second wife, Shirley, and their two sons. Looking for his next hit, he wanders into the studio of Exxon Records producer Jack Clement.
he dropped by one day, and, you know, we'd drifted back to the control room. And I had a tape on it by Dickie Lee singing it, who wrote it. But the melody was a little different. He'd written that last line, "She thinks I still care."
Boy, I flipped, you know. I said, "Golly, let me have this thing."
But I thought that melody might be a little bit too popish, so I sung it for him, you know, a little different. "She thinks I still care." Because I do, folks.
"Just because I ask a friend about her, just because I spoke her name somewhere, just because I rang her number by mistake today, she because I haunt the same old places where the memory of her lingers everywhere. Just because I'm not the happy guy I used to be, she thinks I still
I've always tried to be versatile. I've always tried to do up-tempos and novelties and ballads.
George also records "We Must Have Been Out of Our Minds," a groundbreaking hit duet with singer Melba Montgomery.
He was the number one artist at that time, and I was so excited just getting to meet him and to think I might get to record with him. And I sang the song for him in person, just me and my guitar, and he right away he said, "I love that." Said, "I think we can do that."
I think it's what makes George who he is, because he knows a song when he hears one.
George Jones could smell a hit plumb across town.
"I feel tears welling up, going deep inside, like my heart's from a deep bridge, and the sound of loneliness short and painful that I may never shake. You might say that I was taking it hard when she wrote me over the phone. But don't you wager that I'll hide sorrow when I'm a brick rock down and ball. Well, the race is on and here comes pride in the back."
In the mid-60s, there's a whole new generation listening to their radios like George had done in his youth. They're also dreaming of the life of a country singer. George Jones and hits like "The Race is On" become their inspiration.
Huge, huge record. And I remember hearing that song on WCKY in Cincinnati, Ohio when I was a little boy. And immediately became a George Jones fan.
When I got interested in country music, it was 64. I was listening to a lot of Hank Williams and George Jones, Ernest Tubb, people like that. But it used to make me mad. Every time I heard George Jones songs, I couldn't sing like George, you know.
I would have been a kid. I don't remember how old I was when I first heard George, you know. I would have been a kid. I started singing, of course, when I was 8 years old, and I was singing some of George's songs. I'm sure one of his would have been among some of the first songs that I learned. And I liked him, you know, as I got old enough to understand what was going on. George has always been one of my favorites.
George had become one of country music's hottest stars. He kept a schedule of concert dates that often saw him away from home 250 nights a year. George turned to whiskey, pills, and the ever-available honky-tonk Angels to ease his world-weary body and soul. Behind the scenes, Pappy Daly was pushing George's career through an ever-increasing list of record deals.
Well, we took him to Mercury, and he became the artist for their country division, and then he took him to United Artists, and he was the country division at United Artists. And then he took him to Music Corps, and he was the country music division at Music Corps. And so a lot of people have been riding on old George.
By the time Tammy Wynette walked into George's life, she was already an established star.
Something warm to cling to when nights are cold. and gonna be standing by your man.
1968 was the year of Tammy's greatest success, and George had suddenly taken more than a passing fancy to her. Tammy is also locked into an unhappy marriage. And one night, George accepts a dinner invitation from Tammy and her husband. Like a white knight on his charger, George Jones sweeps Tammy up and carries her off.
So I went over there and I had a few drinks, and he called her a bad name, and I called him down on it and turned his table upside down. It's a wonder he had to kill me.
When they left the house that night together, a relationship began that would be the talk of the country music community for years to come. As a couple, they were inseparable, and George pays out an exorbitant sum of money to his own record company so that he can break his contract and record with Tammy and her producer, Billy Sherrill, on the CBS label. Despite a shaky start, George and Billy's relationship will far outlast George and Tammy's.
We were both scared to death. I was scared of him. He said he was scared of me.
Until I got used, to know Billy, and Billy got to know me, and he got to know my feelings that I wanted to do strictly country arrangements and really do the, what they call today, two country or hardcore country.
I think all I did was change the instrumentation around him. I don't think he's ever changed at all. I did ask him to start trying to sing lower in lower keys because of his old records, he's really, really high, kind of annoying to me.
But as soon as he learned me and I learned him a little more and we was able to communicate, it all came about and it worked out fine.
In a pawn shop in Chicago, on a sunny summer day, a couple gazes at the wedding rings there on display.
She smiles and nods her head as he says, "Honey, that's for you. It's not much, but it's the best that I do."
George and Tammy were married in February of 1969. And through the 70s, the Burton and Taylor of country music continually topped the charts.
We had gobs of hits together and big albums, and we were nominated every year, and we never won. Never won one award together.
And he would drive Tammy up the wall. He would never do anything twice the same way. So we'd usually end up him doing his part, and then after he leaves, she overdubs her part where she can harmonize with him.
In spite of the appearance of domestic bliss and the birth of their daughter, Tamela Georgette, all was not well behind the scenes. By 1974, under the strain of George's bouts of drunkenness, their married life was coming to an end.
I'm not putting any blame on Tammy. If I have any blame or feelings towards her at all, I don't think she tried to understand me and help me to understand her and the things going on about us. I think she took the quick way out.
Tammy said one thing's for certain, I don't love you anymore. I throw down the ring and she walked out the door.
George finds himself alone again and remembering times that, despite the fireworks, he would later describe as some of the happiest in his life.
And I've got the urge to tell the world about it.
There had always been a self-destructive element in George. In the next few years, he would give new meaning to the phrase, down and out.
Well, I drank to start with quite a bit more, a lot more than I should have. And then when it seemed like everything in the world was down on me, that's when I just didn't care anymore.
He and Jesus got our own thing going. He and Jesus got it all worked out. Me and Jesus got our own thing going. We don't need any
daddy to tell us what it's all about.
You know, George said, Tom T, let's go out to Las Vegas. Once we're the center. Well, I said, I can't, you know, I'm on tour out here, you know. I got a whole band and a whole bunch out here. He said, yeah, well, I'll be here when you get back. Let's go out to Las Vegas and gamble a little bit. So I said, I can't go. You know, I'd really like to go. But I kind of got the notion that George was getting to feel adventurous, you know, or a little bit, he'd been calm and quiet for a little too long. So I talked my way out of that. I didn't go. I didn't go to Las Vegas. And so I got back to Nashville a few days later and picked up the newspaper, and George had been to Las Vegas, and for some weird reason or another, he wound up in New Orleans kicking the windows out of a hospital. So that's I got to reading the paper, and I said, you know, I'm kind of glad I didn't make that trip.
Where does it go? The good Lord only knows. Seemed like it was just the other day. I was down in Green Gables, a-hogging them tables, generally blowing all of my heart and pain. By any road blues, I danced toes in the shoes. There weren't another way to be. For them lovable losers and no-account bruisers and honky-tonk heroes like me.
George came to my house one time, and I was hiring a kite. But George was drunker than I was high. And he went crazy. And I'm trying, you know, he kicked me and he swung at me, you know, and he threw things at me, and I'm trying to settle him down. And I can't do it. So I took him down and held him down. And then, but you know what? George ain't very big, but his stuff was lasting better than mine, because I got to getting tired, so I had to tie him up. Laugh about it now, you know, that's about all we can do, you know. It's nothing we can be proud of or anything like that, you know. The ones who can be proud are the ones who never fell into that trap.
All you got to do is think about, down through the years, how George has abused himself. He was almost set on self-destruct.
We drank together, we took pills together, we got in trouble together. We suffered a lot of pain together, but we had some, what we thought were some great times together.
And I think a lot of what us old country boys have done down through the years is basically we were trying to have a good time. And then suddenly it dawns on you that, you know, you're not really having that much fun.
And in spite of all the things that he has done to destroy himself, and would have destroyed 99%, of the other people in this business that I know, he can still stroll out on the stage, strap on that guitar and start singing and knock you right out of your seat.
Now I'm just a bartender. I don't like my work, but I don't mind the money at all. I see lots of sad faces, lots of bad cases of folks with their backs to the wall. I need four walls around me to hold my life and keep me from going, oh Lord, astray. Need a honky-tonk angel to hold me tight. She'll help keep me from slipping away.
I can lie. All George wanted to do was sing songs, and that's all. It was a very simple lifestyle, and he could not understand the hoopla and the success he was having. I mean, it's sort of a love-hate situation when you go through that, because every time George would get in trouble, all I know is we would sell more product. And we were a million albums before we knew it.
Bartender's Blues, written by pop star James Taylor, brings George's music into the sphere of a whole new audience. Artists as diverse as Ray Charles, Andy Warhol, Linda Ronstadt, and Bonnie Raitt drop backstage to pay their respects.
A rock and roll singer pretty well summed it up. I was with Nick Lowe and Elvis Costello in the recording studio. And I was playing a demo by George Jones, and Elvis Costello and Nick Lowe were sitting there with tears in their eyes. They were drinking a little bit, but Elvis Costello said, held that bottle up, said, "The greatest country singer in the history of the world, George Jones." I said, "You're right."
He was sitting in my office at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and we had this huge event planned in New York at the Bottom Line. It was George Jones and country music comes to New York. That's the way it was built. And it was really a big event in New York. A lot of top press was gonna be there. As I recall, most of the cast, I think, from Saturday Night Live was gonna be there. It was a great media event, and certainly an event for country music in New York. And we made our plans, the travel arrangements and so forth. George excused himself from my office, left, and we didn't see him for 3 weeks. He just did not show up. And that was the first in a series, and we ultimately dubbed him No Show Jones.
George's life is in turmoil, both emotionally and financially. Missed concert dates turn into entire canceled tours, and lawsuits from promoters pile up. He frequently disappears for days on end, and then suddenly turns up at some out-of-the-way roadhouse or honky-tonk to perform for the people who had always been closest to his heart. George was running from the star system that threatened to swallow him up. The race was on, and George was falling back fast.
Me time and keep me from slipping. Why?
I mean, it's the damnedest project I've ever worked on. We're dealing with all this negative press. Promoters were down on him. Radio was down on him. Everybody hated him except his fans.
Well, we put in an incredible amount of hours in the studio. And like some of those songs, one verse would be a year away from a chorus because he would come in and his voice wouldn't be up to it. So he'd get a few lines. And like in He Stopped Loving Her Today, the recitation was done 18 months after the first verse was.
This was back during those bad days, and I carried that song about almost a year.
Took forever for him to. He sang it to the tune of a Christopherson hit.
Take the ribbons from your hair, he stopped loving her today. Da 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 da.
I said, "That's not the melody." He said, "Yeah, but it's a better melody." I said, "It might be. Christopherson would think so too. It's his melody." And so finally, he learned a different melody, and we did it.
So often, somebody will take your song, and it'll come. It comes back to you, not quite what you had in mind when you wrote it. It's not as good. Maybe the way the artist interpreted it. But you get a George Jones singing your song, it's just it's like having somebody breathe life into your song.
He kept her pictures on his wall. Went half crazy now and then. Oh, but he still loved her through it all. Hoping she'd come back again. He found love letters by a bed. Did it 1962. But he had underlined in red every single "I love you." I went to see my friend today. But I didn't see no tears. All
I stop to go away. First time I'd seen him smiling you. He stopped loving her. It placed a rip upon his door. Soon they'll carry him away. He stopped loving her today.
You know, she came to see him her last time. Oh, and we all wondered if she would. And it kept running through my mind. Well, this time, he's over her for good. He stopped loving her. It placed a rip upon his door. Soon they'll carry him away. He stopped loving her today.
The last words Young said about he stopped loving her today was, "Nobody will buy that morbid son of a bitch."
The winner for the 1981 Male Vocalist of the Year is George Jones.
Well, I'm on the Jones board, and I just want to say one thing. I'm very proud. And I still love Johnny Wright and Kenny Wills.
Thank you very much. We love country music. It's about time we got back to
life. He Stopped Loving Her Today was George's biggest hit, and it came as his life had finally reached a crisis point. His irrational behavior worsened with his increased dependency on drugs and booze. Emulating his idol Hank Williams in his last days, he begins living in the backseat of his car with a bottle of whiskey and a cutout of Hank as his constant companions. He started having delusions, and soon an alter ego appeared as George frequently spoke using the voice of Donald Duck. He was a man truly out of control.
Each step I take, Lord, I'm sick. Back to, we all have roles of life to play, and I'll play a good one someday.
And I went to about the lowest as that you could go on the booze. And then when I was at that point, I knew there was no out. There was no good thinking at all. There was no way out of it, so I just didn't care no more, so I went to the other stuff. I went to the drugs, then I really got in bad shape. I got down to about 105 pounds, they said, and I looked terrible, I looked awful, I sung terrible, and I was terrible.
More than being concerned, I felt sorry for him because I saw a man that was destroying himself, and I was helpless. You know, what could I do? There have been a lot of people that had tried and failed, but I felt like that somebody needed to do something.
What have I done?
You are drunk. I want to.
I am not.
Yes, you are.
No, sir.
I was afraid he was going to die. I thought I was going to live forever. You know, and we both had problems with drugs.
Let him take me to jail. But you're not going to do that.
Wait a minute.
Oh, I don't think I really was beginning to see it was out of control because I was so out of control I couldn't see anything.
Wait a minute, Dave. All right, kid, I don't want
And so I called him to come out to the house. He came out there, and I said, George, this is going to sound awful funny coming from me, but you got to do something. You got to straighten up.
The best thing ever happened to me is when some friends got with me and talked me into going to the hospital in Birmingham. And first couple of weeks was the roughest. I hated everybody. I still didn't see no way back. And I said, you just wait till I get out of here or something. And in the last couple of weeks, you know, you're in there, you got time to think. You're getting your body back in shape, your mind back to where you can think. I think I had an IQ of 72 when I went in there. And you know, thinking and talking with your doctor and being alone where you can think and seeing, and then having some fine cards and letters coming in from so many fans that really gave you that big lift that you needed, you know, to get you back on the right track. And I met Nancy right after I got out of the hospital.
I think he was needing someone that he could trust and someone that he felt close to, and it took a while to get him to that route, you know, because of being all through, which no secret to anyone, all through the bad times that George has had.
I think if George Jones hadn't have moved back to Texas, I don't think he'd live this long.
Back to the piney woods of East Texas, back to the big thicket where George and Nancy marry, and the possum takes his first steps down that long road to recovery.
We got him interested in a piece of land out here. My husband went out there and found it for him. And so we got his mind on something else instead of on his problem.
I always figured someday we'd help him. And I guess it just took a long time to do it.
It took a lot of years to get him to understand that you can cope with life without picking up a drink and trying to settle it with that. So I think he's come to the conclusion that this is, you're not getting any younger and you're not gonna get anywhere by drinking.
If it hadn't been for Nancy and the prayers and the cards and letters and the people that, the fans that really care, I think that's really what made me think and get to thinking and make my mind up. I said, well, there's somebody still cares and I believe I can do it again.
I've had good luck and bad luck, and no luck, it's true, but I've always been lucky with you. I've been turned on and turned down when the bars close at 2, but I've always got lucky with you. I keep 2 strikes against me most all of when it's down to just a phone call, I'm minus a dime. I've had good days, bad days, but when my day is through, and I've always been lucky.
You know, he's a fighter. He comes back and he just continues to be great always. And I just can't imagine what country music would have been like without George Jones.
He's one of them that's still there when some of them still lying dead along the way.
That's what's so funny. They counted him down and out 9,000 times, you know. And he just keeps coming back, you know. But he always will be here, you know. He'll always be a part of country music. Some of this will last for a while, you know, but as long as there is a country music, you'll know who George Jones was.
keep two strikes against me most all of the time. When it's down to just a phone call, I'm minus a dime. I've had good days, bad days, but when my day is through, and I've always been lucky with you. Yes, I've always been lucky with you.
To be happy, if you're ever lucky to live long enough to be finally, to finally be happy, it was worth it all.
Well, I feel dear, well enough, going deep inside like mountains.
As he entered the 90s, George Jones began recording for MCA Records with the release of Along Came Jones. As he continued an extensive touring schedule, his MCA albums were critically acclaimed, though didn't garner the sales success of his early recordings, mostly because Jones thought radio wasn't programming classic country artists. In 1992, he led a boycott of radio, yet ironically in the same year was inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame. Recognized as one of the true voices of country music, Jones starred in a television special entitled George Jones Live in Tennessee. Then, following heart bypass surgery in the summer of 1994 and a very successful collaboration record entitled The Bradley Barn Sessions, George reunited with his ex-wife and duet partner Tammy Wynette for a tour and album entitled One. In 1996, Jones published a riveting autobiography that placed booze and drugs at center stage of his life, aptly titled, I Live to Tell It All. In the spring of 1998, Tammy Wynette died after a long illness. Then, while completing his first album for Elektra, Jones was critically injured in an automobile accident near his home. It was discovered later that he had been drinking while driving and entered a rehab program to dry out once again. Remarkably, Jones experienced a rebirth following his near-death auto accident. The release of Cold Hard Truth in 1999 received great reviews, and he found himself touring once again, though on a limited basis. To this day, George Jones, admittedly sober and working as hard as ever, continues to tour, even as he celebrated his 70th birthday on September 12th of 2001.
I may never shave. You might say I was taking it hard when you wrote me over the call. But don't you wager that'll hide the sorrow I may lay right down and ball. Well, the race is on. Here comes pride of the backstretch. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running. For another son, the race is on. It looks like heartache, and the winner loses all. Dirty love never once suspecting what the final result would be. I live in fear like an
up each morning thinking that you're gone from me.
Well, there's aching in vain
in my heart for the dear little one I hated to face. Somebody new came up to win her. I wound up in the 18th place.
Is on.
Here comes right at the back stretch. Heartache, I'm going to be inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running room. I'm stressed for another three. Race is on. It looks like heartache. The winner loses all.
Hey.
The winner keeps losing it all.
You can bet old Jones will show up, and we're going to do it.
Darling, there's talk around town about a girl who spreads love. With soft lips and eyes crystal blue. Darling, say it's not you. They say she comes in alone and stays till self respect is gone, and it's like she leaves with someone new. Darling, say it's not you. At first, what they said, it didn't hurt. Until they mention her name, and then slowly the tears overtook me. 'Cause her name and yours were the same. Each night till the breaking.
Thank you so much. Here's one we hope you might remember and recall. What are you doing to me?
Just because I asked a friend about her. Just because I spoke her name somewhere. Just because her number by mistake today. She thinks I still care. Just because I haunt the same old places where the memory of her lingers. Hell. Just because I'm not the happy guy, Lord, I used to be. She thinks I'm still
care. But if she's happy thinking I still need her, then let that silly notion bring her cheer. Oh, but how could they ever be so foolish? Now, well, that old gal gets such an idea. Just because I ask a friend about her, just because I spoke her name somewhere, just because I saw her then with all the pieces, she thinks I still care. She thinks I still care.
Thank you.
Just because I ask a friend about her, just because I spoke her name somewhere, just because I saw her then went all to pieces, she thinks I still care. Just because I haunt the same old places where the memory of her lingers everywhere, just because I rang her number by mistake today, she thinks I still care. But if she's happy thinking I still and let that silly notion bring her cheer. But how could she ever be so foolish? Oh, where would she get such an idea? Just because I ask a friend about, just because I spoke her name somewhere, just because I saw her then went all to pieces, she thinks I still care. She thinks I just because I ask a friend about her, just because I spoke her name somewhere, just because I rang her number by mistake today, she thinks I just because I haunt the same old places where the memory of her lingers everywhere, just because I'm not the happy guy I used to be, she thinks I
nobody's ever seen it, but it's got the whole world shook up. It all started with a little bitty kiss and a hug. It's a little bitty titty bitty thing they call love. Well, I was ruling the roost, I had all the chicks to myself. But then suddenly it happened, a funny little feeling I felt. Well, I tripped down to run it, it finally caught up with me. But how could it run something that I can't see? Well, the race is on and here comes pride at the backstretch. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running. Cruel love's crashed for another's sake. The race is on and it looks like heartaches. And the winner loses all. Well, I feel tears welling up, cold and deep inside, like my heart's from a big break. And the stamp of loneliness sharp and painful, I may never shine. You might say I was taking it harder when you broke me off of the call. But don't you wager that'll hide the sorrow when I'm in brick rock down and ball. Oh, that little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. Nobody's ever seen it, but it's got the whole world shook up. It all started with a little bitty kiss and a hug. It's a little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. Yeah, little bitty teeny weeny thing they call the love bug.
Say that I'm the only one who loves her. I can't say I make her happy all the time. There's someone she can't forget. I know she never. What is for, as my heart's concerned, she's mine. She's mine, and yet I know someday I'll lose her. But she'll never take this happiness I've found. I know it may sound foolish when I tell you that I'm satisfied just having her around. Even when she's in my arms, I know she's lonely. Wish that I could take that someone from her mind. But since her mother left our world, she's been daddy's little girl. She's a baby, I'm her daddy, and she's mine. She's a baby, I'm her daddy, and she's mine.
Here we go. We hope you've heard this one. It's one of my favorite songs that I've ever recorded. And as soon as I get started, I'll quit talking. It goes like this. She'll never grace the centerfold Playboy magazine. Chances are you'll never see her there on the silver screen. But she's by far the biggest star the world will never see. But she don't shine for the rest of the world. She's too busy shining on me. Shine on. Shine. I never see. All my baby wants is shine on, shine on, shine on, of your sweet love on me. She won't be asked for autographs like all the movie stars. She won't wear Paris fashions or ride chauffeur cars. But in her jeans, she's the sexy dream that they'd all like to be. But she don't shine for the rest of the world. She's too busy shining on me. Shine on. Shine on. Shine on, though the world will never see. All my baby wants is shine on, shine, shine on, shine on, of your sweet love on me. Shine on, of your sweet love.
Yeah. tell me my life, how am I wrong? Sweetheart, tell me my life, I am wrong.
I've heard the sound of my dear old mama crying, and the sound of the train that took me off to war, and the awful sound of a thousand bombs exploding, and I wondered if I could take it anymore. When they almost drove me crazy, but I did my best, I took it like a man. But who would think in my lonely sound in the world my heart can't stand to hear that sound and to know it's really over. Through tear-stained eyes I watched her walk away. Closing of the door.
Here's a young man that I vote for as the number one singer in my life, George Jones.
If you'd like to take the grand tour of the lonely house that once was home, sweet home, I have nothing here to sell you, just some things that I will tell you, some things I know. Sits the chair where she'd bring the paper to me and sit down on my knee and whisper, oh, I love you. But now she's gone forever, and this old house will without the love that we once knew. Straight ahead, that's the bed where we lay love together, and Lord knows we had a good thing going here. touch me and say good morning, dear. There's her rings and all her things, and her clothes are in the closet like she left them when she tore my world apart. As you leave, you'll see the nursery. Step right up. Come on in. Step right up. Come on in. If you'd like to take the grand tour of the lonely house once was home, sweet home. I have nothing here to sell you, just some things that I will tell you. Some things I know will chill you to the bone. There sits the chair where she'd bring the paper to me and sit down on my knee and whisper, oh, I love you. But now she's gone forever, and this old house will never be the same without the love that we once knew. Straight ahead, that's the bed where we lay in love together, and Lord knows good thing going here. See her picture on the table. Don't it look like she'd be able just to touch me and say good morning, dear. There's her rings, all her things, and her clothes are in the closet like she left them when she tore my world apart. As you leave, you'll see the nursery. Oh, she left me without mercy, taking nothing but our baby and my heart. Step right up, come on in.
I feel tears welling up, calling deep inside, like my heart's gonna break. And the stab of loneliness, sharp pain that I may never shake. You might say that I was taking it hard when she wrote me off with a call, but don't you wager that'll hide the sorrow when I'm a brick rock down and ball. Well, the race is on and here comes pride in the backstretch. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the room. True love's crashed for another sake. Race is on and it looks like heartache, and the winner loses all. Surgeon in love never once suspecting what the final result would be. How little in fear wake you up each morning, finding that you're gone from me. Making a plan in my heart for the day was the one I hate to face. Somebody new came up to win her, I came out in second.
Well, the race is
on, and here comes pride in the back. Heart attacks are going to the inside. My tears are holding back. I try not to fall. My heart is running. Who scratched for another set? Race is on and it looks like carpet. And the winner loses all.
I feel tears welling up, cold and deep inside, like my heart's run a big break. And the stab of loneliness, sharp and painful, I may never shake. You might say I was taking it hard when she wrote me off with a call. But don't you wager that'll hide the sorrow when I'm a brick rock down and ball. Well, the race is on and here comes pride at the back streets. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back, they're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running, true love scratched for another's sake. Race is on and it looks like heartache, and the winner loses all. I adventured in love, never once suspecting what the final result would be. How little fear waking up each morning and finding that you'd gone from me. Aching in vain in my heart, for the day was the one I hated to face. Somebody new came up to win her, I wound up in second place. Well, the race is on and here comes pride at the backstretch. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back, trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running, true love's scratched for another's sake. Race is on and it looks like heartaches, and the winner loses all.
My goodness, okay. Y'all are wonderful tonight here in South Louisiana. With all your boudin, crawfish, and all that good stuff like that. I'll tell you one thing, we moved down here to Karen Crow. I gotta tell you about that. I gotta tell you a little bit about that. I come from, here lately, I come from Karen Crow. That's close to Love. It's a beautiful place down here, though. We're gonna have a good time tonight. We want you to stay with us. And we're gonna start this one off if the boys are ready. Well, I feel tears welling up, pouring deep inside like mine. And the style of loneliness, sure painful, I may never shake. You might say I was taking it home when you wrote me over the call. Don't you wager that'll hide the sorrow, I may let run down and fall. Well, the race is on, here comes pride at the back stretch. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. My heart's out of the running. True love is stretched for another shake. The race is on. It looks like heartaches. Thank you.
adventure that love never wants is bigger than what the following laws would be. How little the fear of waking up each morning thinking it should go for me. Burning brain in my heart for a jealous one I hated to face. Somebody new came up that went hard. I wound up in 13th place.
The races.
So, here comes pride at the back stretch. Heartaches going to the inside. My tears are holding back. They're trying not to fall. Oh, my heart's out of the runner. Love's scratched for another trip. The race is on. It looks like heartaches. And the winner loses all.
The winner keeps on losing it all.
Started dripping in the kitchen.
That's George Jones.
And last night your picture fell down from the wall. Today the boss said sorry, I can't use you anymore. And tonight the light bulb went out in the hall. Things have gone to pieces since you left me. Nothing turns out half right.
now it seems
there ain't nothing in my pocket but three nickels and a dime. But I'm holding to the pieces of my dreams. Somebody threw a baseball through my window, and the arm fell off my favorite chair again. The man, he came today and said he'd haul my things away if I didn't get my payments made by 10.
Gone to pieces since you left me. Nothing turns out half right now, it seems. There ain't nothing in my pocket but three nickels and a dime. But I'm holding to the pieces of my dream.
Older faucet started dripping in the kitchen, and last night your picture fell down from the wall. Today the boss said sorry, I can't use you anymore. And tonight the light bulb went out in the hall. Since you left me, nothing turned out half right, not seen. There ain't nothing in my pocket but three nickels and a dime. Well, I'm holding to were my dream. Somebody threw a baseball through my window, and my arm fell off my favorite chair again. The man, he came today and set it home things away. If I didn't get my payments made by 10, things have gone to pieces since you left me. Nothing.
Walk through this wall with me. Go where I go. Share all the dreams with me. I need you so. In life we search, and some of us find. And I look for you a long, long time. And now that I found you, new horizons I see. Come take my hand and walk through this world. Walk with me. Go where I go. Share all the dreams with me. I've searched for you so. And now that I've found you, new horizons I see. My hand and walk through this world with me. Come take my hand and walk through this world with me.
That's wonderful. George Jones, our special guest. George, that's one of my favorite songs of all other great ones you've recorded. That's one of my favorites.
Thank you, Doyle. Thank you.
I was
very
just
much.
Sitting over there talking to my mama, and she said, I wish he would have sung The Wind Up Above. That's one of her favorites.
We'll do it next time for your mother.
What key is it in?
Done forgot.
Just give her the opening.
I've been living a new way of life that I know so.
That's good one. Enough. That's fine.
That's all I got.
We'll finish it up the next time. All right. George Jones, come back to see us anytime.
One that we've had lots and lots of requests for. Walk through this world with me. Walk through this world with me. Go where I go. Share all the dreams with me. I need you so. And life we search, and some of us find. I've looked for you. World with me. Go where I go.
go together.
Step by step like shoes on your feet. We go together.
Just like the sand down in the sea. What good is sugar if you have no tea? What good are you if you don't have me? We go together.
That old feeling that we used to get.
Pass it around. Mighty, mighty feeling, and Pappy's
lonesome. Shh, white lightning.
Well, a G-man team in a revenue stew, searching for a place where he may through. They were looking, trying to look him, but my Pappy's in
the room. Shh, white lightning.
Well,
face turned blue. Lightning started flashing, thunder started flashing.
Shh, what a lightning.
Well,
what lightning.
Well, the city slicker came and he said, I'm tough. I think I want to taste that horrible stuff. He took one slug and he drank it on down. And I heard him moaning as he hit the ground.
What lightning.
Well, achieving the revenues, searching for a place where he may through. They were looking, trying to book him, but my pappy never
moved. Ooh, what lightning.
Oh, that's great. That's what I call a real lip smacker, George. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. Y'all are wonderful. You know, we recorded back in 1955 and 56 a song that Charlie Pride has number one this week that we wrote and recorded back in the 55 and 56. And I just like to do you a little bit of our version of it since we don't do it too often. And here's our version of it. Charlie, I'm sorry. It goes like this.
Tell me why, baby, my baby, why you make me cry, baby, cry, baby, cry, baby, cry. I can't help but love you till the day that I die. So tell me why, baby, why, baby, why? Well, I've got a crow I wanna pick with you, like last time when the feathers flew. You're running wild, kicking up your heels, leaving me home with a handful of bills. Well, I can't live without you, you know it's true. If I ain't no living with you, so what'll I do? I'm going honky-tonk and get as tight as I can, and maybe by then you'll appreciate a good man. Tell me why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why you make me cry, baby, cry, baby, cry, baby, cry. Well, I can't help but love you till the day that I die. So tell me why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why? Well, now, I don't know, but I've heard say that every little dog's a gonna have his day. You better pay attention, don't you dare forget, 'cause I'm just a little bitty puppy, yeah. Well, honky honky tonkin' with my best friend, the thing to do was leave me, but I should've left then. Now, I'm too old to leave you, but I still get sore when you come home a-feeling for the knob on the door. Tell me why, baby, why you make me cry, baby, cry, baby, cry, baby, cry. Lord, I can't ever love you till the day that I die. So tell me why, baby, why, baby, why, baby, why? So tell me why, baby, why, baby, why?
You're something else tonight. Woo! I tell you, it's going to be about 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning before I get tired. I tell you. You better start to treat your man a little bit better. You better wear me a smile every time I come home, honey, not a frown. You better give me everything I need in the line of loving. I'll be your daddy, your little daddy, I won't be around. And I work all day, half of my nights, just to please my little mama.
the dark of the home, I find the house turned upside down. Happy to find you in bed, honey, asleep, just like I left you. Cause if I ain't mistaken, you're the dirty little mouse been a messing around. You better start treating your man a little bit better. A little bit better. Wear a smile and I come home, honey, not a frown. Not a frown. You better give me everything I need in the line of loving. It's gonna be a day your little daddy won't be around. I work every day and every night, I'm dealing with you, mama. And every time I come home, I find my little house turned upside down.
I better find you this time, honey, bed and sleep,
just like I left you. Cause if I ain't mistaken, you're the bunch of little mouse has been messing around. You better start treating your man
a little bit better.
I said a little bit better. I will smile every time I come home. And you better give me everything I need in the life to be a day.
Your little daddy won't be around.
It's gonna come out even if short like a guitar pick, I won't be around.
Here is George Jones.
I know that you're wondering who I dream about. And if I met someone to thrill me so, well, I finally met a girl that turns me inside out. I'll tell you about it, for you want to know. You comb her hair every morning and make sure she dresses just. You